So hello YouTubers, welcome back to our third video. Today we'll learn how to use scanf. So let's directly go to video. I will vanish this previous data. Okay, up you need to declare a variable integer. So what should I say? Value semicolon. Okay, now I'll print. As enter number semicolon space. Now let's look at the syntax of scanf. scanf in brackets quote marks. So what is value? It is integer. So for integer, percent d symbol is used. After quote mark and before completing bracket, give comma, then ampersand, it is, you can say, and the name of variable value. So what scanf does is whatever you enter, which is stored at the address of value. So whenever you will refer value, by that address you will be referring that particular entered value in future. So after scanf, let's do it here only, until here only. Okay, now print enter number. I'll enter, as I'm against superstition, I will enter 13. Click, so it goes back. Now after entering, clear screen. Okay, now printf. Now we'll learn how to use entered number here. So printf entered number equal to again percent d and then value. So no ampersand sign is required here. Now compile, run 13. So entered number is 13. So are you getting it? If not, then refresh the page, watch whole video again. So here we are done with this. Now I'll just change it to a string. Enter name percent s. Enter name percent s. String 1. Okay, compile, 3 errors. So what are the errors? You can see we cannot use string directly. So what we have to do is we'll go for character array. I'll talk about array later. Character, string, and this square bracket. Now again compile. I'll talk about arrays later. One error. Size of string. Okay, sorry, I forget. You need to give the maximum size here only. What you write in square bracket, that is number of elements in this array. Now go, my name Yogesh, enter. So entered name is Yogesh. So let's see, if we go with only character, then we'll have to write percent c. Percent C again. Okay, compile, run. A, entered name is A. Now Alt F9. Suppose I write ABC, then what will happen? Only A will be stored in that variable, that is first entered character. So character is used for only one variable, precisely one character, and character array is used for a string. So there are different data types like long int, double, float. You can refer any website or in further tutorials when we require, I'll introduce them to you. So till then, thanks for watching the video. Subscribe to my channel to get alerts about new videos. And that's all from today.